Welcome to week one of the NFL preseason, where the rookies of today hope to become the stars of tomorrow. It's the Packers and the Bengals coming up next.
Oh, gosh.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Jackson looking to throw right away. From the left side, it's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
I literally put myself into the game.
Yards. Barney, you know when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed, his elusiveness, and the ability to get him on the ground, how tough that is for a defense. But how about his development as a thrower, as a professional? And they run the option here on first and 10. Across midfield, and into Bengal territory. 6 yards there on the keeper at second down.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it, and while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's second and 4.
Bro.
Here's Jackson.
What the heck?
He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
What? How the heck?
A third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down.
How do I already have X Factors?
And he's caught. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 27-yard line. A big third down pickup of 20 yards.
I actually put myself in the game.
Throwing now, Jackson on first down. And he's going to go down here. Sack. They push him back to the 34. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Now it's Jackson. Losing yardage back at the 35. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
How do I have X Factors already?
Now it's Jackson. And unable to connect, incomplete. Give him credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Fourth down, here's Jackson. He'll air this one out for Boyd.
Get the football!
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. In 2021, Jonathan Taylor. And this will be a Packers first down as he's able to get this up to the 37-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Again, it's Taylor.
Come on, Armani, let's block.
And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Thanks to receivers, they'll spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
And meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and 2. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Now a timeout called for by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 47. Escaping the pressure run. 15 yards on the scramble. And this play still live. He faked the spike, gonna throw it. And that is kind of lined up incomplete, so they try to hit him with something you don't see too often. But it doesn't work out.
Barnett came into this game eager to see how they would hold up in man coverage. And on that play, they held up quite well.
Can my receivers please block? What the heck are you doing, bro? How did I already get X Factors? That's me.
And they made no bones about it. They wanted to throw this rookie right into the fire, see what he could do. He shows what he can do there.
And you have to really.
But the thing is that I'm not actually in the NFL.
Playing receiver in the NFL is a difficult task. And for a rookie, all that you have to learn to get on the same page with your quarterback, that's excellent coaching. And how about how he's picked things up?
Picking things up in a big way with a big play in his NFL debut.
Certainly a scouting report special, because Covert was all too aware that this close to the end zone, he's going to become a bigger weapon for that offense. And they were there to help force the incompletion.
And inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. It's a 10-yard gain there to set him up first and goal. They've taken this opening kickoff and marched it right down the field defensively. Not much resistance.
And that's the point, because my admiration is for the guys moving the ball right now. They know what they're doing. Their plan is working. But I flip it over.
Why am I not playing?
Come on, man. They're going to put that ball in the end zone real soon.
First and goal. A good chance for our first touchdown of the new season. To the right side and complete to Hurst. So that'll be no better than an incompletion, and it'll bring up a second and goal. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Jackson. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it. It's up for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Third and goal, Jackson.
Why my character can't catch?
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Now Jackson. Buying time to his left. The Packers unable to pick up the first. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense.
Announcing my name.
Just need a yard here. Second and one. Jackson now. Flushed out right. There he goes, right side. 25. Big yards in on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Well, Lamar Jackson, I mean, he is just a ticking time bomb when he has got the football in his hands, and he explodes, Charles, for a big one there.
So there was the boom, huh? Because that's exactly what happened, right? And you can be in the right spot against him and not necessarily make the play. His talent is so good, and his ability to shift and move on a dime, he is so impressive. Even when you play it right, he can make
it. Can I get at least one touchdown catch? Now I got a chance to get my first touchdown of my career.
Here's Jackson to throw.
Gosh!
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, but first the ball through. It kept them out of the end zone. Jackson, gonna throw on third and goal. Touchdown! Career NFL touchdown, and the Packers had six to their lead. Now, there was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead.
With Jackson. He's got his man in the crossing lane. He'll be crowned well upfield right around the 40-yard line.
And that's me, number 18.
After the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. That is incomplete.
Continue to go to the guys, already gotten into the end zone. But good coverage to make sure that this time it fell incomplete.
Jackson. And his throw is incomplete.
Coverage keyed in on him since that last completion was away. He earned a little more attention on that.
Okay, you got it.
And that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw as well.
Play action. It's Jackson. He's got his target. That's complete. Just before the 35. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion.
For the kind of game he's had so far, he had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep with the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball in his hands.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Now a second and 10. Now Jackson. And that one caught downfield by Bowie. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 13-yard line. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured Bear on the field. Well, just the last thing you want to see here in the first quarter of a new season. Hopefully nothing serious. We'll step aside for a moment. Touchdown in his NFL debut. And the Packers are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. So a good start to the campaign so far for them here in week one.
Yeah, I already know they're going to challenge that.
Oh, he fakes the spike. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that is going to wind up incomplete.
No, that was not that.
Again, it was something you don't see too often. But it doesn't work out.
some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. That's great work with the ball in the air. Never
Let's go, Lamar.
Converged on his man and broke the play up.
Jackson's throw taken in by Watkins here. Touchdown! Quez Watkins, 56 yards. And the Packers continue to pull away here in this first half. As a former DB, you might not like to see them, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right, because once he took off.
Let's go, Armani.
They go play action now. Jackson. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it's caught inside the 30. Touchdown. A big play there. Now with his third touchdown in his first ever NFL game. And the Packers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Huh.
And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick... They'll throw on first down with Jackson.
Go, Lamar.
Rolling to his left.
Lamar.
That's some strong running. Coming up at halftime, I'll go for one personnel.
Man, this guy cannot fumble.
Another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
And you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Well, we've seen Jackson already have success in the first half running the football, and he gets good yardage on the ground again there. I mean, how, I know it's a $64,000 question, Stevie, but how do they contain him better?
You have to win against the blockers ahead of you. If those guys even occupy a defender for even a half a second, then Lamar Jackson...
Oh, my God!
Inside the 15! It's a big play there for Green Bay. 45 yards.
This offense is looking very comfortable here in this first half. Very relaxed, very smooth, very efficient. No wasted motions. Things are definitely going their way. And they continue to move the ball downfield.
This offense in midseason form here in the opener. It's first and 10. Here's Jackson. Forced out to his left. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Lamar Jackson taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Packers will extend. Jackson on first down. This is caught. It's Boyd. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Given 30 yards there. So we've reached halftime here on opening. Looks like we'll have to wait another week to get our first halftime report of the season as we move right along to the second half. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football.
Is he a left-footed kicker?
First and 10, it's Jackson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing the game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Oh, and now some trickery. They fake the spike. And this is going to work. It's caught. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Give them 32 on the play.
And how about what just happened there? Just a total breakdown defensively. They're thinking he's going to spike this, so they let their guard down. But he never had any intention of stopping the clock. He wanted to turn the football.
I just feel like that the Packers are a good team to rebuild. No, because the Chiefs are already a super team, so obviously I don't have to rebuild them.
First and 10. Throwing is Jackson. Airing one out for Boyd. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 29-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. The pass to Boyd, and he brings it in on the crossing route. But he doesn't quite make it, taking it with it, an eyelash, dropped at the one.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. To throw again is Jackson, sliding out of the pocket. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
Pretty secure lead, but what's the harm in adding another touchdown, right? At least that's what they were thinking on that snap. If he wants to add more points, got to bring the throw down just a little bit.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packer. Now Jackson on first down.
How am I so fast?
First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. The passing game continues to be their friend, even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles. They're going back
I'm
to that
so
well.
Fast.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay.
This is actually too easy.
Now it's Jackson. There's that man again. It's complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Jackson. And that is incomplete.
Gardner, you and I have struggled with this for years. You've got the lead. Just take care of the football and burn some of that clock. But there's something to be said for not taking your foot off the gas as well, because you can never have too big of a cushion. That one, though, falls incomplete.
And it's a Packers touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Packers are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Well, Charles, no matter what the prognosticators say before the season, whether they think you're going to be good, bad, or somewhere in the middle, you never quite know how week one is going to play out. But for them, it has been an impressive. Despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front. But their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns.
No, how do I already get X factors?
Until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out because this one, it was over a long time ago.
On third down, Jackson. And this one is incomplete.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
And here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. He's got a rifle one deep left side. But that's
oh my gosh!
It's a big play there for Green Bay. 46 yards.
And even with the game seemingly in hand, they're continuing to fire away, pressing the ball down the field. Listen,
let's go, Lamar.
No reason to go away from it now.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. A give for Taylor running right side. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. And that final kickoff concludes the ball game. Partner, one side, a really nice win in this one. They were good on offense and on defense.
And I'm guessing in the other locker room, partner, the head coach is just telling his team, hey, we didn't play well enough to keep it close enough where that one possession down the stretch might have given us an opportunity to win the game.
So for the Packers, it's a fantastic start as they roll to a blowout victory here in the season opener. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Atlanta to take on the Falcons. Meanwhile, for Chicago, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucs.
Bro, I almost gathered 400 yards receiving.
I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the...
That would have been a record. I almost got 400 yards receiving all alone. Okay, so...